एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ट्रैक एसी लाइन स्विचिंग एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 46524। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स सी द कंपोनेंट्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द किट। सो दिस इज द ट्रांसफार्मर सेक्शन। फ्रॉम हियर वी विल गेट 220 वोल्ट आउटपुट एंड वी विल कनेक्ट इट टू द सर्किट। देन दिस इज द लोड सेक्शन एंड हियर वी आर यूजिंग 40 वॉट बल्ब एज अ लोड। Then this is the triac section and here these are the MT2, MT1 and gate ports. Then this is the switch section. We can on and off by using this switch. Then this is the push button section. Here we are having two push buttons for trigger the triac. Then this is the pulse transformer and this is the circuitry. Here we are having transistors and 12 volt DC supply connection port. Then this is the 12 volt DC supply. From here we will supply the 12 volt DC to the circuit. And this is the main on off switch button. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study triac as line triggered AC power switch. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the L port to the load like this, and then we will connect the N port to the MT1 of triac like this, and then we will connect the other port of the load. We will connect it to the MT2 of triac like this, and now we will connect the MT2 with the R2 port like this. Then we will connect the gate of triac to the G1 port like this. So that is how the connection is done. And before switching on the kit, we have to keep this switch position at off. Now after the connection is done, we will switch on the kit and we will switch on the S1 switch. So here you can see that the bulb is glowing. Now we will observe the waveform across load. So for that we will switch on the DSO and we will connect the BNC probe at the channel 1. And now we will connect the probes across the load to observe the waveform. So this is the waveform which we get at the load. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study triac as DC triggered AC power switch. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the L port to the load like this, and then we will connect the N port to the MT1 of triac like this, and then we will connect the other port of the load to the MT2 port of triac like this, and then we will connect the gate of the triac to the G2 port like this, and now we will connect the 12 volt DC supply to the positive of 12 volt DC supply port like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit and we have to keep this switch position at off, and now we will keep this switch at on so that 12 volt DC will be supplied to the triac and the load will glow. So here you can see that the load is glowing. That means the triac got triggered. So that is how we can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study triac as self-latching line switch. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the L port to the L port of the push button like this, and then we will connect the N port to the N port like this. And now we will connect the load to the load port like this, and then we will connect this load port to the N port like this. And now we will connect the MT2 to the L port like this. And now we will connect the gate to the G3 port like this. And now we will connect the MT1 to the load port like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit, and we have to press this S2 switch to trigger the track. And here you can see that the track got triggered and the bulb is glowing. So after releasing the S2 switch, we can see that the load is still glowing. So for off the load, we have to press this S3 switch. And when we press this S3 switch, we can see that the load gets off. And here also on the kit, you can see that at S2 switch start is mentioned and at S3 switch stop is mentioned. So when we press S2 switch, the bulb gets start like this, and when we press this S3 switch, then the bulb gets stop. So by pressing the start, the track got triggered, and when we press this S3 switch, the bulb gets off. So that is how we can perform this experiment. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.